Flexibility methods in analysis of the structures. The analysis is carried out by the equation, that is displacement matrix equals flexibility matrix into the matrix of the load. This method considers the redundant forces as unknowns, and hence this method is also called as the force method. This method is also called as the force method. Here we will consider the redundant forces as the unknowns in the analysis. Here it can be carried out using first one is system approach, second one is element approach. Here now in this study we will study the system approach. Here, the statically indeterminate structures can be analyzed by writing the compatibility equations in terms of the flexibility coefficients and the selected redundance. Here, by using this equation, the structures can be analyzed by writing the compatibility equations in terms of the flexibility coefficients and the selected or any convenient redundants. By making use of the redundants, we can write the compatibility equation. Here, this method which involves the calculation of the displacements due to the external load and the selected redundancies in the release structure. We have to draw the release structure by selecting any convenient redundancies, and then we have to calculate the displacement due to the loads, external loads, and the displacement due to the unit loads in place of the redundancies in the release structures. Here the release structures, by releasing the selected structures, selected redundancies, and which shall be stable. If it is unstable, it will create a problem. Then it should be stable. Here, to develop this equation for the flexibility method, here we have to consider a beam as shown in figure. Here this one is a proper cantilever, continuous beam with two supports, R1 and R2 are the two supports, and is subjected to loads in different spans as shown in figure with moment of inertia I1 and I2. Lengths are L1 and L2. Here this one is the beam subjected to point load in span AB, in span BC subjected to UDL. Here, first we have to find out the unknown reactions. First we have to identify the unknown reactions at fixed end. Usually there are three reaction components, MEA, VA and HEA. But by observing the beam, no horizontal or inclined forces. Hence we have to consider MEA, VA as the only two unknowns at fixed end, A. At B, R1 is the support reaction at P, or the moment at B is the unknown, either anyone, R1 or MB. Similarly, at C, R2 is the reaction, that is the end support. The total number of unknowns are 1, 2, 3 and 4. Then, here, the available equations of equilibrium. Available equations of equilibrium are, one is the summation of the moments of all the forces about any point A equals 0. Similarly, sum of the forces along y axis or vertical direction equals 0. Only we can use the two equations of equilibrium. Since no horizontal forces, no need to apply the horizontal equilibrium equation. Then the degree of indeterminacy is given by DOI, that equals number of unknown reactions minus available equations of equilibrium. Hence, the degree of statical indeterminacy is 2. Then, after getting the degree of indeterminacy, we have to select any two as the redundants. Any two convenient reactions here. Now, in this case, we will consider R1 and R2 reaction at B and reaction C as the redundants. After selecting the redundants R1 and R2, now the structure is released by removing the supports at R1 and R2. Now the structure becomes statically determinate and is stable. Then here at the point where the reactions are acting, that is at B and C, we have released the structure, we have removed the redundant reactions. Then here the displacement due to the external loads at 1 or at B, that is delta L1. Similarly, the displacement at 2, that is delta L2, due to the applied load at C, that we have to calculate. Then after knowing the values of the displacement at loads, displacement due to the loads at 1 and 2 or B and C, now we have to remove the loads. In place of the loads, apply the redundants one by one. That is, first we have to apply the unit load. In place of the redundant R1, we have to apply the unit load at this point. Then we have to calculate the flexibility coefficients. That is F11. Here this one is F11 means the displacement, that is flexibility element means the displacement at the point 1 due to the load applied at 1, that is linear displacement. Linear flexibility means that is the displacement due to unit load or unit moment acting at that point or at any other point. Here F11 equals F11, that is flexibility coefficient at 1 due to the load applied at 1. Similarly, here at C, that is F21, that is the flexibility coefficient at point number 2 due to the unit load applied at 1. Similarly, apply the unit load at point C at coordinate direction 2. Then again, we have to calculate the flexibility coefficients, that is F22, that is the displacement at 2 due to the unit load applied at 2 or point C. Similarly, the flexibility coefficient F12, that is the displacement at 1 due to the load at 2. Now, after getting the flexibility coefficients F11, F21, F12, F22, now we can use the principle of superposition. Here, by observing the diagram, by observing this diagram, here delta L1, the displacement at B and displacement at C are equal to 0. Linear displacements are equal to 0. Then by principle of superposition, displacement at 1 due to the applied load plus the displacement due to the unit load applied at 1 due to the unit load at 1 due to the unit load applied at 1 into R1. R1 is the redundant, plus the displacement at 1 due to the unit load acting at 2 into R2, that equals 0. Here the total upward deflection and downward deflection must be equal to 0. By using this equation, similarly delta L2, that is displacement at C due to the applied load plus the displacement at 2 due to the unit load applied at 1 into R1 plus displacement at 2 due to the unit load acting at 2 into R2, that equals 0. Here, by using the equations, that is F11, F12, these are the flexibility matrix elements, F21, F22, into R1 and R2 are the redundants. Then, by using these, we can form the flexibility matrix and the redundant matrix. Then we can use the matrix algebra to calculate the redundants. Here, by using the above equation, here we can come to the conclusion, that is by using the above relation or by above equations, we can use this equation to analyze the redundant matrix is given by inverse of flexibility matrix into, that is the displacement settlement matrix due to the settlement or sinking of the support minus the displacement due to the applied load. Here R is the redundant matrix, F is the flexibility matrix, delta is the settlement or sinking of the support, delta L is the displacement due to the loads applied.